Hello everyone. Today we are exploring how to set up scrollable horizontal list view. Often list view support up to 10 fields. But adding 10 fields can make the data harder to read and manage. Some have also asked if it is possible to increase the width of each field for better visibility. So let's dive in and make list view more flexible for user. It's just temporary solution for doc type. If you have some basic knowledge of using inspect element, you will find this easy to set up and develop. This video is just for fun. So let's get it started. Go to the sales order. Here you can see I added a 10 field. So it's difficult to view the all details in the sales order list view. So first we open the inspect and first we increase the column size. So we have to find the column name like list row call. Here you can see it's a common class. So first we have to add the minimum width. Like 120 px. Here you can see effect will be. Also we have to set the max width 120 px and effect is apply. So column size is increased, you can see. Now we have to create the list view client script. So add the client script like SO list view scrollable. List, enable the client script, add the basic syntax like Frappe dot list view setting cells order, refresh function list view. Now we have to use the document dot query select all. When you need to style, change or add event listener to multiple element, then you have to use the document dot query select all, because we have to apply for the multiple elements. So for each function call, call dot style dot minimum width is equal to 120 px. Also we have to set maximum width. Now we have to increase the subject column, because subject column is added with the checkbox. So just added like minimum width 200 px Here you can see column width is increased properly. Also set the max width. Now same, copy the document dot query select all. Add the 200px. And add the class list test subject. Now reload the page. Let's check script is work or not. Here you can see column width is increased properly, but it's not scrollable. Or total quantity, grand total is showing mismatch. So we have to increase, but we have to first make the scrollable division. So just add the class Frappe test list. We have to apply for the horizontal, so overflow test X. So here you can see scrollable is working properly. So copy the class name. Let main container. Now we have to use the document dot query selector. This is useful for the selecting unique element like specific button or single component for the form or dialog. So we use it, and we have to apply the style main container dot style dot overflow x is equal to auto. Now we have to increase the list row head. So here you can see class is already applied, so we just check width fit to content or max content. So here you can see width is increased for the list row head. So again copy the document dot query select all and copy that class and paste it. But we have to change the style. You can also use the fit to content. Now same thing, we have to apply for the list row container. So just check it, width. So here you can see data show properly. So copy the class and paste it, save it. Again reload the sales order doc type for the script is running or not. So script is running. Here you can see, but I think last two row is not showing properly, so we have to check what is the actual issue. So I think maybe it's a flags issue. So we have to remove the flags, because flag box automatically adjusts the layout based on the screen size. So when remove it, so its data show properly. So again, we have to copy the document.querySelectAll and copy the list row and level right. Oh, again, we have to copy the list row and level right. Add the style like flex. Set 0. Let's check the final output. So here you can see, now you can view the proper data in the list view. Let's disable the sales order script. Enable the script. Before, sales order look like, and after sales order showing properly, you can check the difference. But default sales order list view row list JS is not properly work, so we have to overwrite the list JS. So reference is already may provide in the forum, so check it. Now we have to overwrite the sales order JS. Let's copy the code. And paste it. Remove the unnecessary score. Also, we have to set Windows dot inner width is greater than 768. So this effect will only on the tablet, and if you are using the laptop or PC. So currently my window size is 1440. Save it, and again reload the sales order, because we have to check default sales order list view JS is apply or not. So here you can see status is coming properly. All detail is coming properly, and you can also check the difference. So thanks for the watching.